Welcome to Quicken Loans Arena in downtown Cleveland, everybody, for the MAC semifinals of the Women's Basketball Tournament. It's the Battle of the Bricks playoff edition this afternoon from downtown Cleveland. The Ohio Bobcats, the number 2 seed in the MAC tournament, taking on the number 3 seed Miami Redhawks. The Bobcats 26-4 overall, 14-4 in the MAC, coming in on a 4-game winning streak, and their last tournament game was here in Cleveland, a 72-56 win over 7-seeded Northern Illinois on Wednesday, in a game where Erica Johnson led the Bobcats with 18 points and 10 rebounds. Miami comes in 23-7 overall, 13-5 in the MAC. They've lost, or won rather, 2 of their past 5, and their last win came on Wednesday as well, a 72-54 win over number 6-seeded Toledo to advance to the semifinals today. That game, Lauren Dickerson and Savannah Kleesner combined for 20 points each. And Dickerson, of course, named in the first team All-MAC on Tuesday with the MAC honors announced. Savannah Kleesner named second team All-MAC on Tuesday as well. So these two teams are going to meet for the third time this year here at Quicken Loans Arena this afternoon. And the first meeting was January 30th in Athens. OU lost in that game. The Redhawks pulled out a 67-61 win in the first meeting of the year. The last meeting, just over a week ago, it was 9 days in Millett Hall on March 6th. Ohio pulled out a 70-66 win in that game. It broke Miami's 4-game winning streak they had, despite the Redhawks overcoming a 23-point deficit at the half. The Redhawks lead the series all-time, 57-33, and the Redhawks are also 7-1 at neutral sites against OU all-time in women's basketball action. The last meeting between these two teams in the playoffs was last year, the quarterfinals on this court at Quicken Loans Arena. The Redhawks winning that game 69-66 to advance to the MAC semifinals, where they would lose in that round last year. And Lauren Dickerson in that game back in the 2018 quarterfinals at 23 total points. So a busy day of MAC tournament action here at Cleveland. Central Michigan and Buffalo squared off in the first game of the MAC tournament. On the women's side, they tipped off at 11 a.m. and Buffalo squeaked out a win in that game over Central Michigan. So the 4-seed Buffalo is going to advance to the championship game tomorrow, and they're going to play the winner of this game. That will be at 11 a.m. And if Miami advances, you can hear that game right here on Red Hawk Radio tomorrow morning in the MAC women's championship game for a chance at a bid at the NCAA tournament. And as of the moment right now, really, none of these teams are going to advance to the NCAA tournament with an at-large bid in the MAC Women's Tournament. So you have to kind of win the tournament to get the automatic bid for the MAC. And so that's what makes this tournament so special and fun to watch. On the men's side of things, a couple of semifinal games tonight for them. Central Michigan, the 5-seed, takes on the 1-seed Buffalo, who's currently ranked 16th in the country in the AP poll last week. They will square off at 6:30 here at Quicken Loans Arena on this court. And 7-seed Northern Illinois will take on the 3-seed Bowling Green, who pulled out a win against Ball State last night. The Falcons and Huskies square off at 9 Eastern tonight after the Central Michigan-Buffalo game here at Quicken Loans Arena. The Mets championship game tomorrow, Saturday, 7:30 p.m., and that game will be played here at Quicken Loans Arena as well. Less than a minute to go now before tip between Ohio and Miami. Coming up next, Kenny Schierlinger and Hans Juste will have the call of this one. Miami and OU in the women's MAC semifinal game here from Quicken Loans Arena, and we'll be back in a moment. You're listening to Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio from the 2019 MAC Tournament.
Safe snowmobiling requires good vision, balance, coordination, and reaction time. Using alcohol and prescription or illegal drugs affects these abilities and impairs snowmobile operation. Alcohol also lowers your body temperature, so it's a dangerous combination in winter weather. No amount of alcohol or drug consumption is ever safe when operating a snowmobile. So it's simple. Don't ride impaired. Brought to you by the American Council of Snowmobile Associations and the Federal Highway Administration. Visit snowmobileinfo.org.
Did you know that generic drugs are just as safe and effective as brand name drugs? Generics might look different, but they work the same way. And they can even save you money. Don't believe me? Ask your doctor or pharmacist. Or visit fda.gov/genericdrugs.
Ranger Station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now.
There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
All right, crew, let's get her dug.
Honey, you wanna give me a hand? I'm planting that tree, remember?
No matter how large
or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. You must call 811 at least 2 to 3 business days before any digging project, so you can avoid hitting our essential buried utilities. This includes natural gas and petroleum pipelines, electric, communication cables, and water and sewer lines. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811. Brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
It only takes a minute to find out if you may have prediabetes, and you can do it at doihaveprediabetes.org. But you're probably not going to. Nope. I'm sure you've got a perfectly good excuse. Kids, work. I get it. You're busy. So what better time than now? Let's begin. Raise one finger if you're a man. Ladies, none yet. Oh, count in your head if you're driving. Now, 3 more fingers for everyone over 60, 2 over 50, 1 over 40, 1 more if you're not physically active, another finger if anyone in your family has type 2 diabetes, another if you've got high blood pressure, if you're overweight, raise another finger, 2 if you're very overweight, and 3 if you're really overweight. You've just taken the world's first audio prediabetes test. And if you're holding up 5 or more fingers, visit doihaveprediabetes.org or talk to your doctor. There's no excuse, because prediabetes can be reversed.
Brought to you by the Ad Council and its Prediabetes Awareness Partners.
Building relationships during recovery from mental and substance use disorders can put the strength of family and community behind you. We're all connected, offering encouragement, support, and hope. Join the Voices for Recovery. Strengthen families and communities.
Welcome to Quicken Loans Arena. Kenny Schierlinger alongside Hans Juste for this semifinal in the MAC tournament between the Ohio Bobcats and the Miami Redhawks. Battle of the Bricks, third edition of the season. Both these teams split the regular season meetings. Both the road teams won. And last week, Ohio got the best of the Redhawks in Millett Hall, beating the Redhawks 70-66. And we're about to get this one tipped off here at Quicken Loans Arena. It's going to be a good one as the tip is up and won by the Redhawks as Lauren Dickerson is going to bring it across the floor. She gets to Leah Purvis in the left wing, trying to get down to Kristen Levering is Kendall McCoy, and she overshoots, so it's going to be the first turnover for the Redhawks of the afternoon. Your starting lineup for the Redhawks is Lauren Dickerson, Leah Purvis, Bailey Reed, Savannah Kleesner, and Kristen Levering. For Ohio, CeCe Hooks, Armani Brook, Erica Johnson, Dominique Dozak, and Gabby Burris. Erica Johnson, top of the key for a 3, and she knocks it home. The Bobcats get on the board first with a 3-0 lead with 9.5 to go, as Erica Johnson, who had 22 points, 8 rebounds, and 3 steals against the Redhawks last week, picks up where she left off. Right wing to Bailey Reed. She's trying to get rid of it to Kristen Levering. She can't get it to her, so she swings it around to the right wing again to Leah Purvis, who drives up and in, no good. And we're going to get a whistle on the floor as we're going to get a foul going against CeCe Hooks as Kristen Levering grabbed the rebound. It's going to be Redhawk basketball on the baseline. Hans, what are the keys for the Redhawks this afternoon if they want to advance into the championship game?
And big key is just to do what they did last time against Toledo, where they shot a very high percentage from the floor and from the three-point line.
Leah Purvis works her way into the lane, driving left and gets it up the window and good. And Miami pulls within 1 of Ohio here.
And good sight for Purvis, the undersized guard, to bring it in the lane on that hard layup.
Gabby Burris drives into the lane, gets it stolen away. It's picked up by Leah Purvis. She's going to bring it across the Miami logo. Miami working from right to left across the radio dial. Long 3 up and away by Kendall McCoy is no good. Rebound by Kristen Levering, and she gets the second chance opportunity to go and lays it up and in. Redhawks on top, 4-3 now. 8.5 to go here in the first quarter.
And that's just a great example of Levering taking the option, taking advantage of the start she's been getting.
Amani Burke, long 3 from the left corner, rather. She knocks it home. 6-4 now. Both these teams starting out hot on offense. Down low to Kristen Levering. She gets the jump hook to go right outside the restricted area. Puts the Red Hawks in a tie, 6-6. 8 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Armani Burke drives into the lane, puts it up, no good. A rebound. Bailey Reed, she hands it off to Lauren Dickerson, coming down the left sideline. Works her way to the top of the key, still holds her dribble. Down low to Kristen Levering, and on the entry pass, it's turned over. It's going to be a second turnover for the Redhawks of the afternoon.
And that's the second turnover, like you alluded, on an entry pass to bring it to Levering, so that's something the Redhawks definitely got to hone in this game.
Here comes Ohio, getting it down to Gabby Burris on the screen, and she goes up with it. It's no good. Tipped up and picked up by Kendall McCoy, and here comes Lauren Dickerson trying to push it a little bit. Driving right. Right jump hook up and away. No good. Secured by CeCe Hooks, and she's going to bring it across the timeline and go coast to coast. Now she's going to pull it out, working on Bailey Reed. Into the lane. Scoop and scores. Good there for CeCe Hooks. She gets on the board for the first time this afternoon. 8-6 lead for Ohio.
And CeCe Hooks is a name you're going to be hearing all night long, all day long, if you guys want to pay attention to that.
Another turnover as Bailey Reed tried to get it down to the left block to Lauren Dickerson, and amongst the trees, she loses it out of bounds. Three turnovers for the Redhawks already. They're going to have to take care of the basketball a little bit better if they want to win this basketball game. Ohio sending up their offense. Long three up and away by Armani Burke from the left wing, and she rattles that one home. 11-6 lead now. 6.5 to go in the first, with Ohio with a little bit of a 5-0 run in the last minute 30. Trying to get it down low is Kendall McCoy to Kirsten Levering. It's turned over. Here comes Ohio driving. CeCe Hooks, she lays it up and in. 13-6 lead as head coach Megan Duffy wants to get a timeout for Miami. She doesn't like what she sees. 7-0 run for Ohio as we're going to take a quick break here at the Cube. This is the Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. We'll be right back.
Safe snowmobiling requires good vision, balance, coordination, and reaction time. Using alcohol and prescription or illegal drugs affects these abilities and impairs snowmobile operation. Alcohol also lowers your body temperature, so it's a dangerous combination in winter weather. No amount of alcohol or drug consumption is ever safe when operating a snowmobile. So it's simple. Don't ride impaired. Brought to you by the American Council of Snowmobile Associations and the Federal Highway Administration. Visit snowmobileinfo.org.
Did you know that generic drugs are just as safe and effective as brand name drugs? Generics might look different, but they work the same way. And they can even save you money. Don't believe me? Ask your doctor or pharmacist. Or visit fda.gov/genericdrugs.
A ranger station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now.
There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
First quarter action already underway here at Quicken Loans Arena, Ohio, with the early 13-6 lead on a 7-0 run. Head coach Megan Duffy wanted to get a timeout before she saw any more of that. She wants to fasten the hatches a little bit here for Miami, try to get back into the swing of things and keep pace with Ohio because they can score it pretty well. Miami fell into a big hole, 40-17 at half against Ohio just last week. They don't want to have that happen again. They dug themselves back to lose only by 4 points, but 17 points in the first half is not going to cut it, especially when you're giving up 40. And Miami's going to have to get it to go. It's going to be their basketball here with 6:22 to go. As Savannah Kleesner has now checked in for the Redhawks, coming in for Kristen Levering. Miami with four turnovers already. And that's really been the difference, as Ohio has been out-rebounded by Miami 4-1. So Lauren Dickinson's going to pull up for a long two. It's going to be no good. A rebound secured by Erica Johnson. She's going to bring it across the MAC logo. She gets it in the right corner for Dozak, who misses the three. It's secured by Amani Burke, and a second chance for Ohio coming here. Gabby Burris launches a three, and she gets it blocked away by Savannah Kleesner, who steals it away and gets it out to Lauren Dickerson, who's pushing it up the right sideline. Dickerson gets to the right wing, top of the key. Now to Bailey Reed in the left corner. Jump shot from the free throw line is good there for Kendall McCoy. She knocks down the 15-footer, pulls Miami within five. 5.5 to go here at the cue. Gabby Burrish driving left, working on Savannah Kleesner. Now she kicks it out. Now to left, the right wing, Amani Burke. Top of the key, Erica Johnson working on Dickerson. Step back three from the right wing. Count it. Erica Johnson. Creates space there to get that shot up and rattles that one home to extend the Ohio lead to 8. 16-8 here at the 5-minute mark. Lauren Dickerson trying to figure out a place to go. She's going to drive into the right short corner to throw up a jumper. No good. A rebound secured by Savannah Kleesner. And she lays it up and in, getting on the board for the first time this afternoon. Kleesner, who has been coming off the bench after Kristen Levering started the last three games. Gabby Burris drives right, lays it up and in. Back and forth we go here. Miami's going to have to get a stop and continue to score. Leah Purvis drives in, gives it off to Savannah Kleesner, who gets stopped. Left wing now to Leah Purvis. She drives into the lane, kicks it out to Bailey Reed. Now to the top of the key, in between the circles, Lauren Dickerson. Dumping it down low to Kleesner, trying to get the tip up to go. It's no good. Here comes Ohio back down the floor. CC Hooks gets her way into the lane, kicks it to Gabby Burris in the left corner for three. That one's going to be a little bit short. Rebound is secured by Kendall McCoy. Miami dodged the bullet there from the wide open three from Gabby Burris.
And it's a rare miss with the way the Bobcats have been shooting out tonight, or today, always saying tonight.
Pretty dark outside with some storms rolling in, so understandable. Miami not unable to get anything to go on offense. They're going to kick it out to Lauren Dickerson. 5 seconds on the shot clock. She's going to have to go. Gets away in the lane. Gets it to Leah Purvis in the left corner for three. That one's going to be short. And rebound is secured there by Erica Johnson. She's going to take it up the floor. The MAC freshman of the year in 2019. Ohio working around the circumference of the arc. Armani Burke drives to the left elbow. Right elbow, rather. And another drive here by CC Hooks, who lays it up off the glass and in. She cashes that one home, and Ohio is up for the first time by double digits, by 10, 20-10 here, just under the 3-minute mark here at Quicken Loans Arena. Long two up and away, and good there by Kendall McCoy. She strokes that one home and pulls the Redhawks. They're going to call that a three. I don't know if that will stick there after they'll review that. It looked like her foot was on the line. Three up and away by Dozak is no good. Rebound, Bailey Reed. And here comes the Redhawks the other way. Lauren Dickerson weaving her way across half court. Now on the left wing, pull up long two. No good. Off a little bit to the right. Rebound, Erica Johnson. She's bringing up the left sideline. Ohio working from left to right across the radio dial. Drive here by Amani Burke, who gets in the lane, and she's going to get fouled. As Savannah Kleesner and her ran into each other. Kleesner tried to take a charge, but she was in the restricted area. So going to the line for two shots is going to be Armani Burke, the 5'9 junior from Columbus, Ohio, shooting at 76% from the free throw line this season.
Armani Burke at the line.
First one up and away, and that one's off the back of the iron. No good. One more coming for Burke. Checking in for the Redhawks is going to be Kennedy Taylor. She's going to relieve Bailey Reed. Coming in for Ohio is going to be Olivia Bauer. She's going to check in for Dominique Dozak. Five for the Redhawks is Kleesner, Purvis, Kendall McCoy, Kennedy Taylor, and Lauren Dickerson. That second free throw is no good. Miami dodges the bullet there. 5-4 Ohio is Armani Burke, Bauer, Hooks, Johnson, and Burris. Right wing, Leah Purvis working on Burris. She drives baseline, kicks it out to Lauren Dickerson. Long two is going to be off the backboard. Way too strong on that one. And Lauren Dickerson looks a little bit off this afternoon. Hopefully she finds her stride.
And it's just a matter of shot selection, which is really hurting the Redhawks today.
Erica Johnson crosses up Lauren Dickerson, gets the runner to go in the lane. Pretty looking move there from the sixth man of the year, sixth woman of the year technically, and the MAC freshman of the year in 2019, the outstanding freshman from Mansfield, Ohio.
And she was just taking advantage of the mismatch with the 5'11 forward against the small 5'3 guard in Dickerson.
She's got eight already. Kennedy Taylor, left elbow jumper, no good. A rebound, Kendall McCoy, she tips it up and in. Kendall McCoy cleaning up that miss there by Kennedy Taylor, picking up her teammate. 22-14 at the minute mark here in the first quarter at Quicken Loans Arena in downtown Cleveland. Gabby Burris in the left corner, swings it to the left wing to CeCe Hooks. She's working on Kennedy Taylor. Taylor's a pesky defender. CeCe Hooks drives in. Lots of contact there. No good. A rebound out to Miami. Here they come. Kennedy Taylor driving left. Goes up into the lane. No good. She forced that one kind of off balance and hit the bottom of the rim. Rebound Ohio as they will have the ball with 28 seconds to go. About a 5-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. 22-14 lead here for Ohio early. Erica Johnson, 10 seconds on the shot clock. She's got Leah Purvis squared up with her. Right wing to Imani Burke. Now to Johnson on the left block. She throws up a wild shot, no good. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Dickerson's going to have to go. She's across the logo. Half-court heave is going to be just short. And that's going to conclude the first quarter here at Quicken Loans Arena. Ohio in the third round between these two teams, leading the way early, 22-14. You're listening to Miami Redhawks Radio. This is Miami Basketball.
We all want our kids to grow up safe and healthy, so we show them how, and we tell them, with honest conversations that let them know what we expect. That's especially important when it comes to alcohol and other drugs. Kids need to know the dangers and how to avoid them. And when it comes to pain medications, opioids, they need to know that they should never be taken without a prescription and never shared with friends or family. It's dangerous and illegal. So talk with your kids, because when you talk, they hear you.
You're not wired to have a response to this sound. You're neutral to it, and you can hear it repeatedly without feeling anything. But when we introduce a new stimulus, save the food, we've achieved pulling a natural or inborn response from you. Save the food. Why are we doing this, you may ask? Save the food. Because this ad is trying to change the world's behavior through brainwashing. Because 40% of all food in the U.S. never gets eaten. Save the food. And that costs a family of four $1,500 a year. Save the food. Cha-ching. It's worsening climate change through the release of methane gas. Save the food. Cha-ching. And it's wasting precious natural resources like our fresh water. Save the food. Cha-ching. So when you hear this sound, don't be neutral. Rethink your behavior. Cook it, store it, share it. Just don't waste it. For tips and recipes, visit SaveTheFood.com. Brought to you by NRDC and the Ad Council.
Many medicines used to treat colds and flu contain acetaminophen, a pain reliever and fever reducer found in hundreds of over-the-counter and prescription medicines. But taking too much or more than one medication containing acetaminophen per day can damage your liver. So always read the label and don't take acetaminophen if you drink three or more alcoholic drinks every day. To learn more, visit fda.gov/OTC pain info. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services Food and Drug Administration.
Denny Schierlinger alongside Hans Juste here at the Quicken Loans Arena. 22-14 lead after the first quarter for Ohio, as Miami's going to have to tighten up in the turnover category, as they've turned it over four times already. Ohio with only one turnover. Miami out-rebounding Ohio 12-8. Four offensive rebounds for Miami, and they've had a couple of second chance opportunities with 8 second chance points already and 10 points in the paint. Leading the way for Ohio is Erica Johnson with 8 points. Leading the way for Miami is Kendall McCoy with 6. She's 3-for-4 from the field. Back to action we go as CeCe Hooks brings it across the timeline. Gets to the right wing to Erica Johnson. Now to the right corner, driving baseline is Amari Burke. And she drives, no good on the layup. Rebound is secured there by Deej Beck, and she misses the tip in. Back to Miami as Lauren Dickerson brings it up the left sideline across the timeline. In between the circles, Abby Hoff, who's checked in for the Red Hawks. Kennedy Taylor on the right wing, working on CeCe Hooks. Now back to Dickerson. Driving into the lane, Leah Purvis. She dumps it in to Abby Hoff, who misses the layup off the backboard. The rebound, Erica Johnson. She brings it up the right sideline, working on Leah Purvis. Erica Johnson, crossover. Now she gets it out to Deej Beck. Now in between the circles to the right wing to Erica Johnson. Top of the key out to Olivia Bauer. Now the right wing. Erica Johnson working on Leah Purvis. She throws up a long three. That one's going to be short. Rebound secured there by Miami and Savannah Kleisner.
And a great defensive stance by Purvis on Johnson.
Right corner, Kennedy Taylor trying to get it down low to Kleisner. She does. Cross court pass out to Leah Purvis, who drives, kicks it to the left wing to Abby Hoff, who knocks down the jumper. Good movement there from the Red Hawks as they get their first basket of the second quarter and pull within 6 of Ohio, as we're going to get a delay of game warning on Miami.
And that's just the benefit of ball movement, like you've said. When you get ball movement, you're going to get an open shooter, and Miami was the beneficiary in that stance.
So the junior, Abby Hoff, doesn't get much playing time, converts there on the jumper, about a 15-footer. Ohio trying to answer here. Ohio's been scoreless in the last 3 minutes. Amani Burke drives to the lane, cutting Deej Beck, who lays it up and in off the glass. She got down low. Got the right finger roll to go. Kennedy Taylor, left wing. Top of the key, Samantha Kleisner. Kleisner drives, gets stopped, and kicks it back out to Lauren Dickerson. Dickerson in between the circles, working on Deej Beck. She feels like she has a mismatch. Gets into the lane. Right jump hook, no good. Off the backboard, a little bit strong. Rebound out to Ohio across the timeline. On the right sideline, driving is Erica Johnson.
Wow.
She kicks it out to CeCe Hooks, top of the key, working on Leah Purvis. CeCe Hooks gets to the right elbow, and it's going to be a backcourt violation going against Ohio, as mishandling the basketball is back. It's going to go back to the Red Hawks. A couple of substitutions in for Miami. Kendall McCoy checking in, as well as Kirsten Lever, and they're going to relieve Kleisner and Huff. 5 for the Redhawks, Dickerson, Kennedy Taylor, Kendall McCoy, Leah Purvis, and Kirsten Levering. Left wing, Leah Purvis. She's working on Dominique Dozak. She drives left, and that one unable to get that one to go. It's rebounded by the Redhawks. Long three up and away by Lauren Dickerson. No good. A rebound out to Kendall McCoy, and the Redhawks have a third opportunity here on offense. Setting up the offense is Lauren Dickerson. High post to Kendall McCoy. She hands it off to Leah Purvis. She's dumping it, trying to dump it down low to Kirsten Levering, and it's almost thrown away by CeCe Hooks. And Levering picks it up and goes up with it. She's going to go to the line for 2 shots after she's fouled. That foul's going to go against CeCe Hooks. That's her first personal.
And Miami kind of benefited from slippery hands on that last position. That could have been easily their fifth turnover of the game, but quick hands on that and able to get to the free throw line.
Levering, first free throw up and away, nothing but net. She converts that first one. She's shooting at 62% from the charity stripe this season. She had 14 points against OU 9 days ago. And that first free throw, or second free throw, is no good. Rims out. Rebound out to Erica Johnson, who's going to bring it across the floor and working on Leah Purvis. CeCe Hooks, right wing, working on Lauren Dickerson. She drives her into the paint. Now hands it off to Gabby Burris, who drives, and she's going to travel. She was trying to get down to the right block. Turnover for the Bobcats. Going back, coming back down the floor with the basketball is going to be Miami. After the Ohio turnover, CeCe Hooks is going to check out of the game for Ohio. Coming in for her is Imani Burke. Dickerson across the MAC logo. High post, Kenna McCoy. Now left wing, Purvis. Right wing now to Kenna McCoy. Drives, cross court pass to the left corner for Dickerson. Long three, that one's off the back of the iron. No good, a rebound out to Erica Johnson. She's going to push a little bit. Driving left is Erica Johnson. She goes up with it and gets hammered down in the lane. She's going to go to the line for a couple of foul tosses. Foul's going to go against Lauren Dickerson. That is her first personal foul. Team first as well. Erica Johnson shooting at 76% from the free throw line this season. She converts the first one there. 9 points already for Erica Johnson. 6 rebounds as well. Approaching the double-double here at about the midway point in the second quarter. Second one is no good there for Erica Johnson. Rebound out to Miami. 25-17 lead with 6 minutes to go here in the second. Dickerson in no man's land. Now she drives inside the arc, driving left. Layup no good. Lots of contact there. Rebound Gabby Burris. She hands it off to Erica Johnson. She wants to push a little bit. Driving right, she's going to turn back around, think twice about it, and pull it back out as Ohio's going to set up the offense. Now a swing pass out to Dozak, who drives baseline. She gets it stolen away, and we're going to get a jump ball. Possession arrow is in favor of Miami. So Redhawks coming back the other way with the basketball as Savannah Kleesner is going to check back in for Miami, coming in for Kirsten Levering.
And that was set up from the tip ball from Dickerson to get Miami to the possession. And she's having a rough day, you know, starting 0-9, and hopefully she can get a good possession to get her going in this early going.
Dickerson trying to pull Miami closer to Ohio in an 8-point hole. Another turnover as Kennedy Taylor tries to dump it down low to Savannah Kleesner.
They're just not getting enough air on those inbound passes into the paint.
Erica Johnson working on Kennedy Taylor. She works her way to the free throw line. Then she kicks it out to Deej Beck. Beck all alone. Gives it off to the top of the key to Gabby Burris. She drives right, goes up with it. Lots of contact, and she's unable to convert the layup. Here comes Dickerson down the other way, pushing it a little bit. Works her way to the right wing. Swings it to the left wing. Leah Purvis gets the high ball screen from Kleesner. Lots of contact there. Unable to free her up, though, on the screen. Back to Dickerson. 10 seconds on the shot clock. They're going to have to go. Dickerson weaving her way. Gets it to Kennedy Taylor inside the arc right side. Out to Leah Purvis. She drives left. Cross-court pass to Lauren Dickerson for a long three from the right corner. No good. A rebound. Kennedy Taylor. She cleans up the rebound for the Redhawks, and they have another opportunity. Kenna McCoy, long three from the left corner. That one's short. Rebound out to Ohio, Imani Burke. She's going to bring it across the floor. Gives it to Dozak, who launches a three, and she converts that three from the right wing right in front of the Miami bench and extends the lead to 11 here for Ohio. That's their largest lead of the afternoon on a 6-1 run in the last 4.5 minutes is the Bobcats.
And that's just the story between the two teams. One is 0-for-8 from three, and one is 5-for-10 from three.
Another three from Lauren Dickerson. Unable to go. That one's short. Long pass out to Gabby Burris, who drives in the lane. Layup up and in, and count it with the foul.
Yep.
As we're going to go to a media timeout here at the Q. One more free throw coming for Ohio after this quick timeout. You're listening to Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio.
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811, brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
We all want our kids to grow up safe and healthy, so we show them how, and we tell them, with honest conversations that let them know what we expect. That's especially important when it comes to alcohol and other drugs. Kids need to know the dangers and how to avoid them. For more information about talking with your kids about underage use of alcohol and other drugs, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov. So don't they hear you. You can do
it if you try. You're not wired to have a response to this sound. You're neutral to it, and you can hear it repeatedly without feeling anything. But when we introduce a new stimulus, save the food, we've achieved pulling a natural or inborn response from you. Save the food. Why are we doing this, you may ask? Save the food. Because this ad is trying to change the world's behavior through brainwashing. Because 40% of all food in the US never gets eaten. Save the food. And that costs a family of four.
Patrick Geshan back with you here at Quicken Loans Arena. Coming up next on the halftime show, we'll take a look at the other action going on in the MAC tournament today on semifinal day here for Cleveland. We'll also take a look at the first half stats analysis and highlights of this game. OU a 30-17 lead over Miami right now. Back to Hans and Kenny.
Thank you, Patrick. Make sure you tune in at halftime to listen to Patrick. Patrick made the trip with us to Cleveland. We got him out of the studio finally, so enjoying his time in Cleveland. A great city with great food, great traditions, and great basketball here. As we got action in March, can't be much better than that. Lots of games on hand tonight. This is the second one. Men's semifinal will be this afternoon and evening. The first one, Buffalo, has already advanced to the MAC Women's Championship, so the winner of this matchup will meet them tomorrow at 11:30. And I believe the MAC Men's Championship tomorrow is at 7. The game will be on ESPN2. So one free throw coming here for Ohio with Gabby Burrish trying to complete the three-point play and extend the Ohio lead to 14. It's up and away. Now it is 14-point deficit for Miami here, 31-17 with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go here in the first half. Miami trying to answer. Ohio on a 7-0 run. Top of the key, Lauren Dickerson working on Amani Burke. Unable to get three, she hands it off to Leah Purvis, who drives in the lane, and we're going to get a charge going against Miami as CeCe Hook stepped in there, took the contact, and that's going to be another turnover for Miami, which has really been the story so far this afternoon. As they are now up to 6 turnovers in the first half.
And with Hooks getting that charge, she's just showing another example why she did win MAC Defensive Player of the Year.
3 up and away, and a shooter's bounce gets as Amani Burke gets that one to go from the top of the key. Miami in a lot of trouble now, down 34-17.
And they just need to get a string of good possessions.
Got to string together some stops and some scores as Kendall McCoy gets a jumper to go from the free throw line. That's her second one from about that same spot. She's come to play here for Miami. She leads the way with 8 points. Driving right and going up with it is Gabby Burris down on her. Behind is Kristen Levering, who snags the rebound, hands it off to Lauren Dickerson, who drives in the lane. Layup up and in off the glass as she gets that runner to go, and Miami all of a sudden is on a 4-0 run.
And that lid has finally opened up for Dickerson. Hopefully that puts a little bit of a pep in her step.
Abby Burris driving into the lane. She turns it over. Bailey Reed snags that one out of the air, hands it off to Lauren Dickerson. Miami with a little bit more life. The crowd and the Miami Fightful come a little bit more alive here at Quicken Loans Arena. Top of the key, Kirsten Levering hands it to the right wing, Leah Purvis. She gets it back to Dickerson at the top of the key. High post, left elbow, Kendall McCoy. Kendall McCoy driving right, layup up and in as she gets the roll to go. She gets Miami's 6-0, gets Miami to a 6-0 run. Miami working into that lead a little bit here, 34-23, 1.5 to go here in the first half. Driving a CC Hooks baseline, reverse layup up and in there. She snuck that one in with the reverse layup. It stops the bleeding for Ohio. Left wing, Leah Purvis, cross-court pass to Bailey Reed, who gets to the right elbow, dumping it down low to Kirsten Levering. It's tipped up, knocked away, and turned over by the Redhawks. Here comes CC Hook, pushing it. Gets to the free throw line, kicks it out to Gabby Burris. Now to Erica Johnson on the right wing, working on Kendall McCoy. She's driving right, floater up and in, and we're going to get a charge as Kirsten Levering steps in there. Erica Johnson in Ohio. And all the Ohio fans over there thought that was going to be a three-point play coming up. But Kirsten Levering steps in there and gets Miami the much-needed turnover as Kennedy Taylor checks back in for the Redhawks, coming in for Bailey Reed. 1 minute to go here in the second quarter and the first half here at Quicken Loans Arena. Miami in a little bit of a hole, 36-23, trying to cut into that lead. Cut it down as close as possible going into the locker room. Dickerson, left wing. She spins around to the top of the key, working on Gabby Burris. Now we're going to get a hard screen from Kirsten Levering. Long jumper, or short jumper, up and away there by Lauren Dickerson. No good. And the rebound's going to go out of bounds. They're going to say it went off the Bobcats, so it should be Miami basketball on the baseline. Some confusion over there on the end, right in front of the Ohio band and the Ohio bench, and all the Ohio fans don't like that call. Right elbow, Kirsten Levering, top of the key, Kennedy Taylor. Now left wing to Lauren Dickerson. Dickerson working on Gabby Burris. Now she gets a switch at the top of the key to Erica Johnson, trying to get it down low to Kendall McCoy, and Kendall McCoy goes up with it. No good. Rebound secured there by Ohio and Dominique Dozak, and we're going to get a foul there on the loose ball. 10.9 to go here in the quarter, as that's going to be the 14th foul going against Miami. It's going to be the first personal foul on Kennedy Taylor here. So last shot coming here in the first half by Ohio. CC Hooks drives in, kicks it out to Gabby, Dominique Dozak. He launches a three. It's going to be no good. And that's going to be it here for Quicken Loans Arena in the first half. So after two quarters, Miami trails at 36-23. As Miami has turned it over a little bit more than they probably should have, with seven turnovers. They out-rebound Ohio 22-17 in the first quarter and have unable to keep Amani Burke, Erica Johnson, and CC Hooks at bay, as Johnson, Burke both have 9, CC Hooks with 8, Miami with only one double-digit score, with Kendall McCoy with 10. She's really been the only one that showed up in another quiet first half in an Ohio-Miami basketball game from Lauren Dickerson, as she was 1-for-13 from the field with 2 points. She was scoreless in the first half and came back firing in the second half with 18 points. So that's what Miami's really going to have to hope for and talk about in the locker room, as they've been in this position before, and it's a little bit better this time as they're only down 13 points rather than 23 at the half against OU a couple days or last week. So with that, Kenny Schierlinger and Hans Justy, we're going to hand it down to Patrick Geshan for the halftime report. Patrick?
All right, Kenny, thank you very much. And yeah, Redhawks need to do a lot here if they want to advance to the championship game tomorrow. 36-23, your halftime score. The Bobcats on top of Miami. And Ohio started that first quarter off on fire. They had a 13-6 lead by the first media timeout. and were able to string together a 10-2 run in the middle of the first quarter. OU ended the first quarter with a 22-14 lead. The Redhawks 1-for-5 in their last 5 field goals of the first. Erica Johnson, the points leader for Ohio, after 10 minutes with 8 points. Kendall McCoy had 6 for the Redhawks to lead Miami. The play kind of went back and forth at the beginning of the second quarter. No team kind of really went ahead all that much, but it was a Gabby Burris and a 1 plus the free throw with about 3:30 to go in the second quarter that really kind of changed the momentum for the end of that quarter, and the Redhawks set a 3-minute, 30-second scoreless streak at that point. That scoreless streak grew to 3 minutes and 49 seconds. Ohio had a 10-0 run at that point in the second quarter. Redhawks tried to come back a little bit, but they had a 6-0 run with about 90 seconds to go in the second, but both of these teams kind of fizzled out in the last 90 seconds or so. The half ends. OU on a 1-minute 31 scoreless streak. Redhawks on a 1-minute 51 scoreless streak. And Miami 0 for 9 in their last 9 three-pointers in this game. They're really trying to get that long ball working, but still haven't made one yet today, this afternoon, with 0 for 9 from beyond the arc. Lauren Dickerson 0 for 6 by alone, just by herself, from behind the three-point arc. So coming up next, we'll take a look at your first half stats and also a look at the out-of-town scoreboard and, of course, the MAC scoreboard with plenty of big games going on here at the Q today in downtown Cleveland. We'll have all that coming up next on the halftime show. Ohio 36, Miami 23 at the half from Cleveland, and this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio from the 2019 MAC Tournament.
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811, brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
Ranger Station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now. There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
All right, crew, let's get her dug.
Honey, you want to give me a hand? I'm planting that tree, remember?
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. You must call 811 at least 2 to 3 business days before any digging project so you can avoid hitting our essential buried utilities. This includes natural gas and petroleum pipelines, electric, communication cables, and water and sewer lines. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811. Brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
Welcome back to Quick and Loads Arena. Patrick Geshan with you here in Cleveland with a halftime report here on Red Hawk Radio. And we'll take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard in just a second. But first, the stats for the first half of this game between Miami and Ohio. In the MAC women's semifinal, Bobcats lead at 36-23 after 20 minutes. Kendall McCoy, your points leader for the Redhawks after 20. She has 10 points. And for Ohio, 2 players tied with 9. Amari Burke and Erica Johnson each have 9 for the Bobcats. And right now, Miami really struggling in the field goal department. They're 11-for-33. They've only made 33.3% of their field goals. The Bobcats, 50% from the field, 14-for-28 they are. And again, like I mentioned in the first segment, Redhawks 0-for-9 from beyond the arc, the three-point land here this afternoon for a 0%. Bobcats, 6-for-12, 50% from the three-point arc, from beyond it, actually, here this afternoon. Only 2 free throws for Miami. They're 1-for-2. Those were attempted by Kristen Levering. For the Bobcats, their free throws 2-for-5 for 40%. Miami leads the rebounds 22-17. The assists, led by the Bobcats 6-4. Each team has 3 steals in the game so far, and the turnovers, another thing to watch. Both of these teams kind of with a good amount of them. Miami with 7 and Ohio with 6. Their score again, 36-23 after the first half. And let's take a look now at your MAC scoreboard in women's action. So this first semifinal at 11 a.m. this morning, played at Quicken Loans Arena. And the 4-seed Buffalo beat Central Michigan in a close game, 82-77. The Bulls and the Chippewas battled it out in the second half. Both teams had leads and great streaks of play, but Buffalo ended up taking that one, 82-77. So they advance to the MAC championship tomorrow on the women's side of things. That'll be at 11 a.m. They're going to face the winner of this game between Ohio and Miami tomorrow morning for the MAC women's championship in 2019. A pair of semifinals tonight in MAC men's basketball. The first one at 6:30 between Buffalo and Central Michigan. And last night's scores were pretty good for 4 games of the quarterfinals. Buffalo knocked off Akron 82-46 in the early game here at Quicken Loans Arena yesterday. Central Michigan beat Kent State 89-81. Northern Illinois knocked off Toledo in a close one, 80-76. And Bowling Green and Ball State battled in the nightcap last night. BG taking that one 99-86 to knock the Cardinals out of the tournament. So again, that first semifinal, 5th seed at Central Michigan and the 1 seed Buffalo, 6:30 p.m. tonight from Quicken Loans Arena in the men's semifinals. And then the second one will be at 9 p.m. Eastern time tonight, 7-seed Northern Illinois against the 3-seed Bowling Green. And another top 25 men's basketball action today and semifinal day across all college basketball conferences. Currently, 2 active games in the top 25 schedule right now. Michigan State and Ohio State in a much-anticipated Big Ten meeting. 8:46 to go in the second half in Chicago at the United Center. The Spartans with a 61-49 lead over the Buckeyes right now. Michigan State, the number 1 seed in the Big Ten tournament. Ohio State, the 8 seed. And in the SEC, LSU, the 1 seed in that tournament, leads Florida 46-38 with 13:16 to go in the second half in that game from the Southeastern Conference. And then one other final today. This comes from the American Athletic Conference. Houston beating UConn 84-45. And Houston looking pretty good as a pretty dangerous tournament team coming into the NCAA tournament, which begins next week. And Selection Sunday, of course, coming up this Sunday. Plenty of other games in the top 25, but a lot to talk about right now. Those are all at night with a lot of 7 and 9:30 p.m. Eastern time starts. So coming up next year on the Halftime Show, I'll join Hans Justy, and we'll talk about that first half for Miami and what they need to do to get back in this game and have a chance at the championship tomorrow at 11 a.m. That's all coming up next on the Halftime Report. Ohio 36, Miami 23, and you're listening to Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio from the 2019 Mid-American Conference Tournament.
A ranger station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yep, he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now. There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
All right, crew, let's get her dug.
Honey, you want to give me a hand? I'm planting that tree, remember?
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. You must call 811 at least 2 to 3 business days before any digging project so you can avoid.
Patrick Eshuwedi here with Hans Justy on the Halftime Report. Ohio 36, Miami 23 at the half here from Quicken Loans Arena. And Hans, talking about this Miami team trying to get back in this game in the second half. And one of the things you noticed the Red Hawks were not doing well was moving the ball in the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, for sure. And with Dickerson, obviously she's a talented guard, and a lot of the onus is put on her to dribble the ball, to penetrate, and to make plays for her team. And that's obvious with her points per game and with her assists. But with it, she's not been put in favorable situations where she can score easily. So in the second half, like, obviously, if they want a chance to win this game, she's going to have to put the ball in the hole. But she needs to get a little bit better opportunities with moving the ball and them helping her out to put her in, you know, more favorable situations for them to cut into this lead.
And then beyond the three-point arc, Miami 0-9. They've really got to clean that up if they want to get back in this game. Just think, if they made 5 three-pointers in that half, it'll be a much closer game, maybe even tied at this point. So what do you do to get more three-pointers in the basket?
Yeah, and the onus in that is ball movement, and you're seeing that with OU. And OU's threatening Miami a lot on offense because of the three-ball threat that they have. They're stretching them out, making them, you know, run all the way to the three-point line, and that's giving them opportunities to actually drive. I mean, Miami's put up 9 threes, so it's not like they're not swinging the ball around, but a lot of it is you got to start the pressure from the three-point line. If you got pressure from the three-point line, you got defenders reaching you out from there, that's going to open up your drives. That's going to open up McCoy a little bit more, and Klusner, and your other bigs. But for real, I mean, Miami, they just got to hit them. They shot 9. I don't think they were terrible shot selections on them, but I mean, a few from Dickerson, she had to do off the dribble, but really just on catch and shoots. And if you're open, you know, let it fly and not worry about the ones you missed.
Right. All right, Hans Justy with us here at the halftime report, talking about what Miami needs to do better in the second half if they want a chance at winning it. They trail Ohio 36-23. That's that for the halftime report. Kenny Schierlinger and Hans Justy back with the second half call when we return to Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland. And this has been the halftime show, and you're listening to Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio from the 2019 Mid-American Conference Tournament.
Ranger Station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now. There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
Safe snowmobiling requires good vision, balance, coordination, and reaction time. Using alcohol and prescription or illegal drugs affects these abilities and impairs snowmobile operation. Alcohol also lowers your body temperature, so it's a dangerous combination in winter weather. No amount of alcohol or drug consumption is ever safe when operating a snowmobile. So it's simple. Don't ride impaired. Brought to you by the American Council of Snowmobile Associations and the Federal Highway Administration. Visit snowmobileinfo.org.
Did you?
Second half action almost about to get underway here at Quicken Loans Arena as Miami is trailing the MAC East champs 36-23 as we are about to get through with halftime here, and it's going to be do or die time for Miami. They want to extend their season. They're going to have to come back firing, find a way to come back and win this basketball game. And I think the way you do that, Hans, is you're gonna have to get Lauren Dickerson going, mm-hmm, or somebody else going, because you got to find another scorer besides Kendall McCoy, who stepped up to the plate. She's 5-for-8 from the field with 10 points, and you just got to hit some threes. They're 0-for-9, and yep, you just got to hit a couple of them. Keep shooting them if you got the open looks, but you don't want to settle. So Hans, what are you looking for Lauren Dickerson in the Miami offense to get going, so they could cut into this lead and get even back with this Ohio basketball team?
Yeah, well, first, I want them to forget about the first half, especially if you're Dickerson. And when you're a talented scorer, you can't remember the last miss you had. She's got to forget the first half she had. But a lot of it is just a little bit of ball movement, a little bit of help. She's penetrating a lot. She's got the ball in her hands a lot. But a lot is not moving because it's all congested. So if they want to give her a chance to score, they need a little bit more ball movement and give her a little bit of easier positions for her to score and to help cut into this lead.
Patrick Geshan highlighted a couple of stat lines over halftime, but I think the biggest one stands out to me personally is Miami out rebounding Ohio 22-17 with 8 offensive rebounds. Miami with 14 points in the paint and 9-0 advantage against Ohio in second chance points. So that Miami's doing the right things. They just got to clean up the fat a little bit here and start scoring, stringing together some stops and some scoring possessions, and they'll be just fine and hopefully have a meeting with Buffalo tomorrow in the MAC championship. Back to action we go as Ohio has the ball first. Driving baseline is Imani Burke. She throws up a runner. No good. A rebound, Gabby Burke. She gets it out to Erica Johnson for a long three in the left wing. She knocks that one right through the nylon and gets that one to go. 39-23 lead. Not the start you wanted if you're head coach Megan Duffy and the Miami Redhawks.
Yeah, worst case, the offensive rebound and then the open wide three to extend their lead.
Miami trying to answer the quick three. Kendall McCoy launches a long three from the top of the key over Erica Johnson. Long rebound out to Gabby Burris. And here comes Ohio trying to build off their massive lead that they've built. 39-23, 9-10 to go here in the third quarter. Erica Johnson working on Leah Purvis in the on the left wing. Now Gabby Burris in the right wing. Drives baseline, gets some open space. Reverse layup up and good off the glass. 5-0 run for Ohio to start the second half here at Quicken Loans Arena.
And if you're going to be off a three-point shooter, you really can't let them blow by you like that. That's a very poor defensive possession.
Driving Leah Purvis, she gets to the right left wing to Bailey Reed, who misses the quick jumper. Here comes Ohio down the floor. CeCe Hooks in and out dribble, loses her dribble for a second, and takes it back to the top of the key. Dominique Dozak driving inside the arc, kicks it out to Gabby Burris, who launches a long three. That one's short, flat shot, and she didn't really elevate there on the jumper. Rebound out to Leah Purvis. She's going to bring it across the timeline. Miami working from left to right across the radio dial. Top of the key, Savannah Kleesner. She swings it into the left corner and gets it to the right block to Kendall McCoy. Long three, long away from Lauren Dickerson. She knocks it home as she looks like she wanted to hit that one. And excited on that long three as we're going to get a blocking foul against Miami going to the line for two shots. It's going to be Dominique Dozak. And Lauren Dickerson, after she hit that three, she looked over to her bench and looked like she unleashed some of that nervous energy that she has been building up. And Miami knocks in their first three. They're 1-for-11, 9% from beyond the arc. But that's a start here in the second half.
I mean, it's a lot different when you got an open look, which is what OU's been seeing all day. So if you get string a couple more of those, you know, hopefully cut into this lead. But you got to start now.
First free throw up and away by Dominique Dozak. And that one's good. Second one coming for her. She knocks that one in. Converting 2-for-2 is Dominique Dozak. She has 5 points on the afternoon. Trying to get it down low is Leah Purvis, the Savannah Kleesner. It's no good. Rebound out to Ohio.
And those download passes are really not working for the Redhawks at all today.
Erica Johnson launches a three from the right wing. And guess what? She's fouled. So she'll be going to the line for one shot to try to complete that ever so rare four-point play here. With 7:38 to go, Ohio has picked up exactly where they left off in the first half. Up 46-26, 20-point lead, largest lead of the afternoon for Ohio. Free throw up and away, and that one is good. Converted by Erica Johnson. 21-point lead for Ohio over Miami here at Quicken Loans Arena. 7:38 to go. You're tuned in to Miami Redhawks basketball on Redhawk Radio.
Many medicines used to treat colds and flu contain acetaminophen, a pain reliever and fever reducer found in hundreds of over-the-counter and prescription medicines. But taking too much or more than one medication containing acetaminophen per day can damage your liver. So always read the label and don't take acetaminophen if you drink three or more alcoholic drinks every day. To learn more, visit fda.gov/OTC pain info. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services Food and Drug Administration.
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811, brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
We all want our kids to grow up safe and healthy, so we show them how, and we tell them, with honest conversations that let them know what we expect
That's especially important when it comes to alcohol and other drugs. Kids need to know the dangers and how to avoid them. For more information about talking with your kids about underage use of alcohol and other drugs, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov. So don't they hear you. You can do it if you
try. We all want our kids to grow up safe and healthy, so we show them how, and we tell them, with honest conversations that let them know what we expect. That's especially important when it comes to alcohol and other drugs. Kids need to know the dangers and how to avoid them. And when it comes to pain medications, opioids, they need to know that they should never be taken without a prescription and never shared with friends or family. It's dangerous and illegal. So talk with your kids, because when you talk, they hear you.
Kenny Schierlinger, Hans Juste, Patrick Geshan on the ones and twos here. Ohio, the MAC East champs, trying to repeat what they did last week, a win against the Redhawks, and they look pretty good so far. Up 21 points with 7:38 to go here in Cleveland. Winner of this basketball game gets to advance to the MAC Women's Basketball Championship against Buffalo. Miami's really going to have to start stringing together a handful of stops and a handful of scores if they want to get back in this basketball game, and you just can't get it back all at once. That's the mindset that I would assume that Megan Duffy was saying in that huddle right out of this break, and I think that's what they're going to try to do here as Miami's going to have the basketball once again, trying to cut into the 21-point lead, largest lead of the afternoon for the Bobcats. Dickerson on the right wing gets rid of it to Kendall McCoy. Jumper from the wing extended is no good. Long off the back of the iron. Rebound, Erica Johnson. She's going to bring it across the floor. Johnson hands it off to CC Hook. She's working on Leah Purvis. Now to Johnson in the left wing. Long jumper, and she traveled there as she picked up her dribble. Erica Johnson leading the way for Ohio with 16 points. 5 for 7 from the field, and she's 4 for 5 from beyond the arc. The MAC Freshman of the Year in 2019, playing just like it here in Cleveland in the MAC tournament. So Miami back with the basketball. Left wing, Lauren Dickerson. Works her way to the top of the key, now swings to the right wing, Leah Purvis. Right elbow, Kendall McCoy. She gets into the lane as she tries to bank it off the glass. No good. A rebound out to Kirsten Levering. Second chance opportunity for the Redhawks. Kennedy Taylor, right wing, top of the key. Lauren Dickerson working on Gabby Burris. Steps inside the arc, then steps back out. Long three, Dickerson. That one's going to be a little bit long. A rebound out to Kendall McCoy in the lane, and she gets it stolen away. Loose ball is picked up by Kirsten Levering. And with 6:20 to go, the Redhawks have a third opportunity to score on this possession. 15 on the shot clock. Miami's going to have to go put their offense in the motion. 10 now on the shot clock for Leah Purvis in the left wing. She picks up her dribble, gets trapped. Down low to Kendall McCoy, goes up with it. Lots of contact, no call. Missed layup there for Kendall McCoy. Coming down across the MAC logo is Erica Johnson. Crossover behind the back in the lane. Jump runner is no good off the front of the iron. Here comes Lauren Dickerson. She wants to push it a little bit herself. She's going to pull it out. Gets it to the right wing to Kennedy Taylor. Down low to Kirsten Levering, who turns it over down on the right block. Here comes Erica Johnson pushing it. Kicks it in the left corner for three. No good by Imani Burke. A rebound out to Leah Purvis. Up and down we go. Both these teams unable to put the ball in the hoop in the last couple possessions. Cutting, Lauren Dickerson pulls up for a quick jumper. That one's short and a little bit left. Rebound, CC Hook. She's weaving in between the defense. Drives left. Layup up and in, and the foul. And they're going to call a charge, actually, as Lauren Dickerson stepped in there. So it's going to go. Oh, no, they're going to say it went against Dickerson. So CC Hooks will go to the line for the three-point play opportunity with one shot coming.
And that is something to watch, too, with Dickerson getting her third foul and now getting substituted for her first break of the game. So it's going to be a different look for the Miami Redhawks offense with her off out of the game.
Kenzie Schmitz checks in for Dickerson. That free throw is good. 50-26 lead for the Bobcats here with 5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Leah Purvis gets it to Kenzie Schmitz, who drives right. Layup is missed there, a little bit long off the backboard, and Gabby Burris grabbed the rebound, and she's going to get called for the travel. So with 4:59 to go here at Quicken Loans Arena, Miami in a very big hole, 50-26. You're listening to Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. We'll be right back.
Many medicines used to treat colds and flu contain acetaminophen, a pain reliever and fever reducer found in hundreds of over-the-counter and prescription medicines. But taking too much or more than one medication containing acetaminophen per day can damage your liver. So always read the label and don't take acetaminophen if you drink three or more alcoholic drinks every day. To learn more, visit fda.gov/OTCPainInfo. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services Food and Drug Administration.
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811, brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
We all want our kids to grow up safe and healthy, so we show them how, and we tell them, with honest conversations that let them know what we expect. That's especially important when it comes to alcohol and other drugs. Kids need to know the dangers and how to avoid them. For more information about talking with your kids about underage use of alcohol and other drugs, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
Ohio 50, Miami 26, 4:59 to go here in Cleveland in the MAC Women's Semifinal. Hans, what does Miami have to do here to get back into this basketball game and at least make it interesting and respectable? Because this, for a lot of seniors here in Miami, this will be the last time they touch a basketball court in arena and on the hardwood, especially in competitive play. You might be playing some rec ball or some pickup basketball later on, but this has got to be a do or die here for Miami, especially for their seniors.
I mean, of course they got to score, but they got to stop Erica Johnson, number four, the freshman of the year. I mean, she's got 16 points and 8 rebounds, and she's really been the engine that's got her team going. So if they can slow her down, they can cut into this big lead that they got. But that's definitely the player they need to key into.
Five for the Redhawks, Taylor, Schmitz, McCoy, Levering, and Purvis. As Miami gets it stolen away by Erica Johnson, as Kennedy Taylor passes it right into the hands of Erica Johnson. She brings it across the floor, swings out to Gabby Burris in the right wing for a three. That one rattles in and out. Rebound, Kendall McCoy. Here comes Leah Purvis down the left sideline. Miami working left to right across the radio dial. Top of the key, driving is Kendall McCoy. She gets it out the right wing. Kenji Schmitz, top of the key, now to Levering. Cutting Kristen Levering, unable to find her. Right three, three from the right wing is no good by Kenji Schmitz. Rebound out to Ohio, and Erica Johnson's going to slow it up, taking over point guard duties. Erica Johnson, the combo guard, can do it all. She can score, she can bring it down the floor and handle the basketball, and she can play some defense as well. Driving Armani Burke, and she misses the layup, but it's going to go out of bounds off the Redhawks. So staying with the basketball is Ohio. It's going to be their basketball on the baseline. Bailey Reed checking in for Miami, as well as Leah Purvis, or Kennedy Taylor. No, Lauren Dickerson and Bailey Reed check in for the Redhawks. Kennedy Taylor and Leah Purvis out, and we'll take a seat on the bench. Going to get a foul call as Dominique Dozak drives.
Foul on Kendall McCoy.
Kendall McCoy is going to pick up her second personal foul. 14th foul on Miami. Firing in is Erica Johnson into the right corner for Armani Burke, who drives around to the left side and gets that blocked away. Down the other way, here comes Kenji Smits of the Redhawks. And it's turned over as Kendall McCoy tried to get a slipping Kristen Levering. Long three up and away, and count it for Dominic Dozak.
And that's been a big difference. When the Redhawks get a chance to push it in fast break, they slow down. But OU makes sure to keep going. You got a wide open person on the three ball, adds to the lead, and defense isn't set.
So 53-26, 3:37 to go here at Quicken Loans Arena. Listen to Miami Basketball on Redhawk Radio. We'll be right back.
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811, brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
Don't sweat the technique. 53-26 lead for Ohio over the Miami Redhawks here as Miami takes a quick 30-second timeout to regroup. And they're in a lot of trouble here with the basketball. Just trying to make this game respectable here. Top of the key, Abby Hoff turns it over, and it's a loose ball picked up there by Dominique Dozak. She gets it out to Erica Johnson. It's the 12th turnover, actually, for the Redhawks this afternoon. Weaving into the lane, CeCe Hooks. Now she drives right, goes up with it, and it's blocked away by Abby Hoff. Out of bounds off of Miami. Very good defense there from Abby Hoff, the junior forward. Savannah Kleesner checking in for Miami. She's going to come in for Kristen Levering. Kennedy Taylor also coming in for Bailey Reed. Five for the Redhawks. Taylor, Abby Hoff, Kenji Smits, Lauren Dickerson, Savannah Kleesner. Driving baseline is Dominique Dozak. Long three up and away, and that one's going to be way short. Rebound secured there by Savannah Kleesner. Here comes Miami down the other way. Kennedy Taylor dumps it down low to Abby Hoff. He goes up with it, sneaks the basketball right off the window and in. 12-2 run in the last 5 minutes for Ohio as Erica Johnson gets that runner to go. 55-28, 2.5 to go here in the third quarter. Lauren Dickerson, top of the key, now gets it to Savannah Kleesner. Now Abby, or Kenzie Smith's in the left wing. High post, Abby Hoff trying to dump it down low to Kleesner, and it's going to be a loose ball out of bounds off of Ohio. Your five for the Bobcats is Johnson, Dozak, Burris, Burke, and CeCe Hooks.
And OU's giving Miami no space in the paint. They got three people surrounded against anyone who's trying to penetrate there.
Savannah Kleesner, lots of contact down there, gets the right jump hook to go in the lane. 55-30, 25-point lead here from Cleveland, Ohio for the Ohio Bobcats. We're going to get a tie up here. And we're going to get a foul going against Ohio, offensive foul, so it's going to turn it over back to the Redhawks. It's going to be the 10th turnover for Ohio. CeCe Hooks checks out. Deej Beck checking in for Ohio. Across the MAC logo. Working on Amani Burke is Lauren Dickerson. Between the circles, Dickerson drives into the lane. Driving right, goes up with it. No good. A rebound is out of bounds off of Ohio. It's going to stay with the Redhawks on the baseline with 15 seconds to go on the shot clock. Ohio showing no mercy so far with all five of their starters in the basketball game except for Deej Beck, and it's turned over again by the Redhawks. Was all five starters until Deej Beck just checked in a couple of seconds ago. Long pass out to Dominique Dozak. She launches a three from the right wing. It's going to be no good. A rebound secured by Ohio. It's going to be a foul is going to go against the Redhawks, so it's going to stay on the far end of the floor. Inbounding it is Erica Johnson. She gets it in the Deej Beck, top of the key. Working on Abby Hoff. She tries to get it in to Erica Johnson. It's turned over, picked up by the Redhawks, and coming down the floor is Lauren Dickerson. Long stretch pass out to Abby Hoff, and Savannah Kleiser drives in. She's going to get fouled on the drive right. Going to the line for two shots is going to be the 6'2 junior forward from St. Charles, Missouri, Savannah Kleisner. She's shooting at 70% from the free throw line this season. She had a double-double against OU last week. 11 points, 12 rebounds in Millett Hall in Oxford, Ohio. She converts that first one. Second one coming here for Savannah Kleisner. Up and away, and she rattles that one home. 2-for-2 trip there for Savannah Kleisner. As Miami has put on the full court press, almost turned over by Ohio. It's going to stay with Ohio as they say that one off of one of the red jerseys. Getting it in is Dominique Dozak. She is trying to get it in. She gets it into Imani Burke, who's working on Laura Dickerson. She surges ahead across the timeline and hands it off to CC Hooks. CC Hooks working on Kenji Smits in between the circles. Now the right wing. Imani Burke. Now in between the circles, Dominique Dozak. Now to Erica Johnson. She's working on Abby Hoff. She drives her right, gets it to Gabby Burris, and we're going to get a foul going against the Redhawks as Gabby Burris caught it in the middle of the lane. She tried to get something to go towards the basket. It's going to go against Kenji Smits. That's her first personal team fifth. It's going to the line. Now the bonus, Ohio and Gabby Burris, who's shooting at 75% from the charity stripe this season. That one rattles in and out for Gabby Burris. She only had 4 points against Miami. She was the only Bobcat to foul out in Millett Hall a couple of days ago. She has 8 points tonight as she converts that second free throw. Leah Purvis bringing it across the Miami, or the MAC logo. Working on CC Hooks in the right wing. Top of the key, Savannah Kleisner. Left wing, Lauren Dickerson. Dickerson drives into the lane, goes up with a right jump hook, no good. A rebound, Erica Johnson pulls in her 10th rebound, double-double for Erica Johnson. 18-10, three assists, four steals. Erica Johnson showing why she is the MAC Freshman of the Year in women's basketball. CeCe Hooks driving right, full head of steam, goes up, and they're going to call a charge. Or no, they're going to call a blocking foul. So that's going to be an and one for CC Hooks. She was full head of steam going right towards the hoop. Lays it up and in, and she's got one free throw coming for her. She converts that one. 59-32 lead with 8.1 to go here in the third quarter. Erica Johnson's going to take a seat on the bench and get a quick breather. Lauren Dickerson driving, gets to the right elbow, jumper short, rebound Dominique Dozak, and that's going to conclude the third quarter here at Quicken Loans Arena. Nothing has really changed here in the third quarter in the second half. Ohio still up big, 59-32. We'll be back for the fourth quarter of action. You're tuned in to Miami Basketball and Redhawk Radio.
Safe snowmobiling requires good vision, balance, coordination, and reaction time. Using alcohol and prescription or illegal drugs affects these abilities and impairs snowmobile operation. Alcohol also lowers your body temperature, so it's a dangerous combination in winter weather. No amount of alcohol or drug consumption is ever safe when operating a snowmobile. So it's simple. Don't ride impaired. Brought to you by the American Council of Snowmobile Associations and the Federal Highway Administration. Visit snowmobileinfo.org.
Did you know that generic drugs are just as safe and effective as brand name drugs? Generics might look different, but they work the same way. And they can even save you money. Don't believe me? Ask your doctor or pharmacist. Or visit fda.gov/genericdrugs.
A ranger station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now. There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service Ad Council and your state forester.
All right, crew, let's get her dug.
Honey, you want to give me a hand? I'm planting that tree, remember?
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any.
Couple of seconds here at the Quicken Loans Arena. Miami struggling to keep up with the Ohio Bobcats, down 59-32. They're going to have to pull off some March magic if they want to make this one a game and try to get it to the MAC Women's Championship tomorrow. Leading point getter for Miami, still Kendall McCoy with 10 points. And those 10 points all came in the second half, in the first half. Kristen Levering with 5, Lauren Dickerson with 5. She's 1 for 8 from beyond the arc. William Purvis with 2. Savannah Kleiser with 6 and Abby Hoff with 4. Herdog's back with the basketball. Kennedy Taylor driving into the lane, kicks it back out. Top of the key, high post. Kenji Smith, or Savannah Kleiser, she tries to get to Lauren, or Leah Purvis. It's almost turned over. It's going to stay with the Redhawks, though, with 12 seconds on the shot clock. 9:41 to go.
And Purvis was just sitting on that three-point arc, just waiting for the ball. You got to be quick on those passes and keep your eyes open.
Got to step to the ball as well, or it's going to get stolen away more times than not. Long three up and away by Kristen Levering. That one's short. Catches the bottom of the net, out of bounds, going back to Ohio. CC Hooks bringing it across the timeline. Long pass out to Gabby Burris, who drives baseline. Dumps it off to Deej Beck, who goes up, and she's going to get fouled. Fouled on the shot. So two free throws coming for Beck. Sophomore guard from Grand Rapids, Michigan. Deej Beck at the line. First free throw up and away, and good there for Deej Beck. One more coming. Kendall McCoy checks in for Miami for Kirsten Levering. For second free throw up and away, and she converts both of them. Beck with 4 points. She's 2 for 2, perfect from the charity stripe this afternoon. Miami trying to get a bucket. Working around the three-point arc. Kennedy Taylor driving baseline. Layup is just short. Rebound Savannah Kleisner as she goes up with it. She's going to get fouled. Never say die. Savannah Kleisner, she rescues the possession, and she's going to go to the line for the second time this afternoon. She's 2 for 2 from the free throw line tonight, or this afternoon. 6 points for Savannah Kleisner. She's 2 for 3 from the field as well. First one up and away and good. She has 4 personal fouls, though. She's going to have to be careful with 9:05 to go. 61-33. One more coming here for Savannah Kleisner. From St. Charles, right outside of St. Louis. Rebound is secured there by Kendall McCoy off the missed free throw. And we're going to get a jump ball possession arrow in favor of the green and white from Athens. Miami with full court pressure. Kennedy Taylor pestering CC Hooks. CeCe Hooks blows past her across the timeline and slows it up. Now she has Dickerson on her. Hooks gets into the lane, swings it into the right corner for a long three. Nothing but net there from Imani Burke. The 5'9 junior guard from Columbus knocks that one home. She's shooting at 40% from beyond the arc this season. Leah Purvis driving. Now she's got it back, driving left. Layup no good, off the front of the rim and popped out. Bringing it down the floor, CeCe Hooks, the sophomore guard from Dayton. She drives right, lots of contact, no good on the layup. The rebound, Savannah Kleesner. Here comes Dickerson, pushing it. No numbers for her. She tries to pull up, gets stopped, kicks it out to the trailer for Kendall McCoy, who misses the long three from the top of the key. Back with the basketball is CeCe Hooks. In between the circles, she approaches the top of the key. Steps inside the arc for a second. Now she's going to drive right, turn on the Jets. Layup, no good, short. Rebound out to Deej Beck. She cleans it up.
Deej Beck.
Gets that one off the backboard and in. Cross-court pass from Dickerson to Leah Purvis. Trying to go down low to Savannah Kleeser. It's batted away and picked up by Kennedy Taylor, who goes up with it. She's going to get fouled. She threw up a runner from the right block. Imani Burke's going to pick up her second personal foul. Team second. Army with only one personal foul, or team foul. First free throw up and away is no good there from Kennedy Taylor, who's shooting at 58% from charity stripe this afternoon. She had three points against Toledo in the quarterfinal. One more coming for her. Kaylee Bamble coming in for Ohio for the first time this afternoon. Dominique Dozek is going to take a rest. Kendall McCoy out for Miami. Abby Hoff back in for the red and white. Second free throw is good there for Kennedy Taylor. 66-34, 7.5 to go here in this basketball game. Game two of four here at Quicken Loans Arena. This is the last women's semifinal today. The two men's semifinals later this afternoon and evening. We're going to get a tie up, and it's going to go to Miami. Five for the Redhawks, Leah Purvis, Savannah Kleesner, Abby Hoff, Lauren Dickerson, Kennedy Taylor. Five for Ohio, Imani Burke, CeCe Hooks, Gabby Burris, Kaylee Boomble, and Deej Beck. Driving baseline is Abby Hoff. She gets it out to the right wing. Leah Purvis, who gets it to the right or top of the key, pulls up for a step back three. That one's no good. Out to CeCe Hooks. She's weaving across the timeline, working on Kennedy Taylor. Deej Beck, top of the key. Gabby Burris, right wing. Top of the key, back to CeCe Hooks, who drives right. Layup is good as she was fading away from the basket and laid it up and in. Pretty looking move there for CeCe Hooks as she gets her 16th point of the afternoon.
And she just loves driving on that right side and kind of throwing her body.
Long three up and away, no good from the top of the key by Lauren Dickerson. That one's going to go out of bounds right in front of President Crawford, who's made the trip, about the 4-hour and 10-minute trip from Oxford up here to Northern Ohio on the shores of Lake Erie. Across the MAC logo, typically where the Cleveland Cavaliers C would be. CeCe Hooks, she's going to take her time as she's going to drive left into the left short corner, working on Leah Purvis. She gets it down low to Gabby Burris. She goes up with it. She's going to get hammered on the shot on the right block. She's going to go to the line for two foul shots.
First, team second. Gabby Burris shooting two.
Gabby Burris, two shots coming for her. 75% free throw shooter, knocks that one in. Nothing but net.
Kenzie Schmitz returns for Miami.
Kenzie Schmitz coming in for the Redhawks, checking in for Leah Purvis. Second free throw up and away, and good there for Gabby Burris, the 5'11 sophomore forward from Baltimore, Ohio. She knocks in her 10th point. She's in double figures. 5 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 steals. Lots of steals for all these Bobcats. As Miami has not taken care of the basketball at all in the first or second half. 14 turnovers for Miami as Kennedy Taylor works her way into the paint, lays it up and in. 70-36 now. 5:20 to go here in the fourth quarter. Olivia Bauer working on Abby Hoff. Kicks it out to Armani Burke. She gets it in the Deej Beck, who drives baseline, and she stepped out of bounds. Basketball goes back to Miami with 5:07 to go. Ohio with a very comfortable lead, and it looks like they're going to start getting in the substitutions as Armani Burke's going to check out for the Bobcats, and probably for the final time this afternoon. You want to save her legs for the championship game tomorrow. Hunter Rogan in for the Bobcats for Burke. Armani Burke, the younger sister of Trey Burke, the former point guard at University of Michigan, took them to the Final Four, losing to Louisville. And technically, they didn't lose Louisville because that championship was taken away by the NCAA after the Louisville scandal, the infractions that they committed. As Trey Burke's still in the NBA, he's put himself together a pretty nice NBA career. As a layup up and in there for Kirsten Levering. And we're going to get a timeout as Miami's going to take a timeout, 30-second timeout. We'll stay with you here at Quicken Loans Arena. So exciting set of basketball, or a lot of basketball going on today. A lot of the conference tournaments in their semifinals. And some of them in the quarterfinals, the Big Ten in their quarterfinals. And we got two big ones coming up in the MAC with Buffalo and Northern Illinois. Coming up next, and then it's the second game, Hans. Second game is
the
fact check on that.
The Bowling Green.
Bowling Green, yes, Bowling Green. And, NIU Bowling Green, and then Buffalo is taking on.
So fans, get up and get rowdy.
Who's Buffalo taking on, Hans?
I cannot remember. I have to look through.
Buffalo takes on Central Michigan tonight, Kenny. 6:30.
So that should be a good one at 6:30 here at the Q. So we're in a media timeout here. Both these teams are going to get their substitutions in and get some players on the bench who are probably not accustomed to playing in an NBA arena, so it should be a good opportunity for them. Miami getting in their younger players with some more experience. The future is bright for Miami. They're 22-7 on the season overall, 13-5 in conference, getting to the semifinals this year. Got to believe they'll be right back in it next year, contending for the MAC championship. Ohio definitely has a very good nucleus going with Erica Johnson, Armani Burke, CeCe Hooks. All the three of those players are going to be coming back for Ohio next season. Dominique Dozak was a senior. She'll be exiting the program. Gabby Burris still staying. So you have four of your five starters returning for the Bobcats, and head coach Bob Bolden in his sixth year, who is the winningest coach in program history. He actually achieved that in the win against Miami and Millett Hall last week. So we're about to get back to action here as Hunter Rogan, the freshman guard for Urbana, Ohio, is going to inbound it. Miami's still staying with the press. Checking in for Miami as well is number four, Vanessa Garrelis, the freshman guard. CeCe Hook still in for the Bobcats. Gets it to Hunter Rogan in the right wing, and she drives and loses it out of bounds. It's going to be Miami basketball. Vanessa Galis now in charge of point guard duties here for Miami. Trying to get it down low is Kennedy Taylor to Kristen Levering. She overshoots her, and it's going to be another turnover. 16 turnovers now for Miami. Just hope they don't hit the 20 mark here in the last couple of minutes in this semifinal. CeCe Hooks, right wing. Long cross-court pass to Kaylee Bamble. She gets to the left block. Jumper up and away by Beck, and she follows her own shot, grabs rebounds. Fresh shot clock for Ohio with 3:20 to go here in the fourth quarter. Driving up and no good. A rebound secured by Kennedy Taylor. Hunter Rogan on the drive there. Kennedy Taylor coast to coast, lays it up and in. Finger roll.
Kennedy Taylor.
She gets that one to go. Across the floor, CeCe Hooks. The only starter remaining for Ohio. Between the circles, Olivia Bauer. She drives to the right wing, working on Abby Hoff. It's turned over, picked up by the Redhawks, out to Kenji Smits. She's pushing it. No numbers for her. She kicks it out to Vanessa Galis, who launches a long three. She rattles that one home. Second free three for Miami. Comes with 2:19 to go in the fourth quarter. Vanessa Galis knocks that one in and gets on the board. ...70-43 lead here for the Bobcats. Deej Beck driving into the lane as she gets the shooter's roll to go in. She gets that jump hook to go. Careless across the timeline. Trying to get it down low to Abby Hoff. It's kicked away. It's going to stay with Miami. Coming in for the Redhawks is going to be Kelly McLaughlin. She's coming in for Kristen Levering, the senior. McLaughlin down on the right block. She gets that one to go off the window and good in. Hunter Rogan, point guard for Ohio, drives into the lane. Gets stopped, and we're going to get a traveling violation against Hunter Rogan. 1:31 to go here in the fourth quarter. 72-45 lead for Ohio. They got the lead early in the first quarter and have not looked back since as Miami turns over the basketball there. Miami 11% from beyond the arc, 32%, 19 for 59 from the field. Ohio 45%, 25 for 55 from the field. They're 10 for 22, 45% from beyond the arc, and converting 75% of their free throws. Miami was out rebounding Ohio just about the whole game until recently. Ohio now has the edge by two, 38-36. Free throw up and away by Deej Beck is good. One more coming for her. Points in the paint for Ohio is 28-26 for Miami. Second chance point for Miami. It's one of the only stats Miami really has the advantage in, 10-5. 17 turnovers for the Redhawks is usually not going to get it done as well. 15 for Ohio. But a lot of that has come in about these garbage minutes in the late fourth quarter and third. really hasn't made much of a difference. Those turnovers for Miami came early in the first quarter and really kind of catapulted Ohio out to their early lead, and they haven't looked back since, as they are up with 55 seconds to go, 74-45. Not the showing you really wanted from the Redhawks here in the semifinals, especially against your arch rival, the Ohio Bobcats. Both these teams do not like each other very well. Battle of the Bricks. And both these teams were tied up in the regular season matchup, both the road teams winning. And Ohio's going to get the best of Miami and win round three in advance to the MAC championship, as they will take on Buffalo tomorrow at the conclusion of this basketball game. And that should be a good one. Buffalo and Ohio at 11:30. Got a stoppage of play here. I think maybe the clock's turned off. Yes.
56.9 seconds remaining.
I'm going to reset the game clock to 56. Vanessa Gehrlich trying to get it in. She gets it kicked away there by Olivia Bauer. Bauer not making it easy on the Redhawks. Kenji Smith's right corner. She has the basketball. Swings it around. Vanessa Gehrlich drives in. Quick jumper. No good. A rebound is going to be out of bounds off of OU. Ohio, rather, as two Ohio players were fighting for the basketball. Gehrlich gets it in as Kenji Smith goes up with it. She was bobbling it there. It was blocked. Crowd wanted a tie-up. Top of the key, Abby Hoff. Kenji Smith's now on the left wing. Top of the key, gets into Gehrlich. Long three from the left wing is way short. Rebound out to Abby Hoff. She goes up with it. It's going to go out of bounds. And they're going to say it's going to stay with the Redhawks. 25 seconds to go in the basketball game. Kenji Smith's in the left wing, driving into the lane, kicks it out to Vanessa Gehrlich. In between the circles, Miami's looks like they're going to hold for maybe the last shot here. Abby Hoff, top of the key, long three, and she knocks it home.
Abby Hoff, 3 points.
And that improves Miami's shooting behind the arc, the 20 or 15%. And at the final buzzer here, Ohio's going to advance to the MAC Women's Championship game tomorrow. Miami will fall and head home back to Oxford, and their season likely to be over with no automatic bid for the Redhawks in the near future. So your final score here at Quicken Loans Arena, 74-48, as Miami falls big against Ohio, and Ohio gets round three of this matchup. As we mentioned, that both these teams split the regular season series. Miami winning in Athens a couple months ago, and OU or Ohio winning in Millett Hall in Oxford, Ohio this past week. The final game goes to Ohio as they will face off with the 4 seed Buffalo. Ohio came into the tournament as the 2 seed, CMU, Central Michigan, the 1 seed, knocked off by Buffalo right before this basketball game, 82-77. And a little bit more of a lopsided basketball game here in the second semifinal, as Miami Redhawks are going to head over to their fans and shake hands with some of their fans, maybe meet with some of their parents who have made the trip. And that's going to do it here at Quicken Loans Arena. Any final thoughts here, Hans, here as Miami falls 74-48?
Final thoughts kind of just goes out to the seniors. We have Leah Purvis as a senior, Bailey Reed, who was a redshirt senior, other seniors, Kendall McCoy, Kristen Levering, just for the play that they had and the effort that they put in. You know, they made it to semifinals. You know, it's still an accomplishment, especially with Miami, you know, being a growing team and second year with Coach Duffy. Definitely shout out to those people. And, they did their thing. And sorry it wasn't the outcome that we wanted, but still had us come out here and broadcast in my last broadcast at Miami.
Yeah, that's going to wrap it up for me as well. Me and Hans are going to be moving on after this year, so it'll be at least the last men's or women's and men's basketball game, basketball, Miami basketball game for me, Kenny Schierlinger, and Hans Juste. It's been a pleasure on Red Hawk Radio as Miami wraps up their season in disappointing fashion, losing to Ohio 74-48. So long for now. For Kenny Schierlinger, Hans Juste, we'll go to Patrick Geshan for the post-game report.
All right, Kenny, thank you very much, and congratulations on your final game at Miami basketball broadcast booth. 74-48, Ohio with a win over Miami this afternoon at Quicken Loans Arena. It was 36-23 OU at the half, and Bobcats came out. Red Hawks maybe had a chance at halftime to try to get something going, but Bobcats just shut them down. They started the third quarter on a 13-3 run, and that eventually grew to a 19-3 run in the third quarter. Third quarter ended 59-32 Ohio, and then fourth quarter kind of back and forth. OU just kind of controlled the play, though, for most of the fourth quarter. The Red Hawks were able to string together an 11-2 run at the end, towards the end of the fourth quarter, but wasn't quite enough to make the comeback for your final score. Ohio 74 and Miami 48. Red Hawks only had one lead in this game. It was a 4-3 lead with 8:36 to go in the first quarter when we were just getting going here from Cleveland. And it's the second straight year the Red Hawks will fall in the semifinals. And like Kenny mentioned, probably not a continuation of the season at this point for Miami in terms of hopes of an at-large bid into the NCAA tournament. Ohio, though, moves on to the championship game. They're going to take on the 4-seed Buffalo tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern. The Bulls, of course, coming off an 82-77 win in the first semifinal of women's action today over number one-ranked Central Michigan. So your final stats this afternoon from Cleveland. Again, OU with a 74-48 win. Red Hawks 20 for 64 from the field, 31.3%. The Bobcats 25 for 55 for 45.5% from the field. Bobcats from three-point land, 10 for 22, 45.5%. The Bobcats almost shooting half of their three-pointers into the basket. The Red Hawks struggling from the three-point. If you join us for the halftime show, you kind of figure that one out. 3 for 20 at the Red Hawks from behind the arc today for 15%. Free throws, Miami didn't have that many opportunities. 5 for 8, 62.5%. The Bobcats, though, 14 for 18 for 77.8% from the charity stripe. The rebound battle was actually led by Miami. The Redhawks had 40 rebounds to Ohio's 38. In the assist department, Miami led that 10-9. Redhawks had 6 steals. OU had 11. In the blocks department, Miami with 6 blocks. Ohio with 3. In the turnovers, Miami finishes with 17 turnovers. And the Bobcats finish with 15 turnovers. So the Red Hawks season likely over at this point, and we'll take a look now at the top 25 men's scoreboard with three finals from action earlier today, and the next game will be at 3:13 p.m. In terms of top 25 action in the Big Ten tournament, that'll be 13-seeded Nebraska taking on 4-seeded Wisconsin in the Big Ten, 3:13 the tip for that game. From the United Center, three finals, though, from earlier today. Michigan State knocks off Ohio State despite the Buckeyes trying to come back late in that one. 77-70, the Spartans win it. Houston beats UConn 84-45 in the American Athletic Conference action. And from the SEC, we have an upset from the SEC tournament. The Florida Gators, 8th seed in the SEC, knock off the 1st seed in the SEC, LSU, by a score of 76-73. That's a big one in that tournament. So LSU, with their hopes of a high seed in the tournament, maybe slashed a little bit with that Florida win, and they're going to move on in the SEC tournament. Plenty of top 25 games going on tonight, including one right here at Quicken Loans Arena. Number 5-ranked Central Michigan will take on number 1-ranked Buffalo at 6:30 in the first semifinal of MAC men's action here this afternoon. And 7th-ranked Northern Illinois will take on the 3rd-ranked Bowling Green Falcons, who knocked off Ball State yesterday at 9 o'clock Eastern. That's the approximate tip of that game here from Cleveland. It'll take place about 30 minutes after the Central Michigan-Buffalo game is done. Championship game tomorrow for the men, 7:30 on Saturday night. The women's championship, 11 a.m. tomorrow. And that, of course, will be the Ohio Bobcats taking on the Buffalo Bulls on the whole women's side of things. So that's pretty much going to do it for us in basketball action tonight. And one other thing to add to the out-of-town scoreboard, the Miami hockey team will begin their playoffs tonight in St. Cloud, Minnesota, taking on the number one ranked in the country, Huskies. 8 Eastern tonight, the puck drop from the state of hockey, and that's going to be a best-of-three series in first-round NCHC action. So Miami If they win that series, they'll advance to St. Paul for the NCHC Frozen Faceoff. If they lose that series, their season probably going to be over. So the hockey team are going to have to come up big in St. Cloud against the number one team in the country with that series beginning tonight. So for Hans Juste, Kenny Schierlinger, for here from Quicken Loans Arena, it sure has been fun coming up to Cleveland here on Red Hawk Radio. And thank you so much for listening to us here this weekend and throughout the season in all sorts of broadcasts, hockey, men's basketball, women's basketball. Appreciate you listening to the student radio broadcast. Of course, baseball season still around the corner, and that's just underway. And Bennett Wise has a bunch of those games for you here on Red Hawk Radio. But thanks for listening in to the student radio broadcast and supporting all of those. As this was the only free radio broadcast of this game this afternoon, so we thank you so much for tuning in. So for Hans, Kenny, Patrick Eschett, saying so long here from Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland. Red Hawks fall to the Bobcats and their season over on the women's basketball side of things. And this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio from the MAC tournament in Cleveland.